Welcome to Load Runner Tutorial 7. In this video, we will learn one more important concept to make our VUser script ready for load testing. This is transactions. Now, a transaction is a part of a VUser script. A transaction is used to measure the time it takes to complete one or more actions of the business process. So here we have the flight booking steps of the flight reservation business process. Against each step, we can see the maximum acceptable response time. So for logging into the application, we have given an example maximum response time of 1 second as per our performance requirements. Now what we need to do is locate this particular step in our VUser script and insert the start transaction marker and the end transaction marker. So let us go to our VUser script and locate where it logs into the web application. So we can go to the step navigator, and here is the step for login. We double click on it and it takes us to the corresponding step in the editor pane. Now we need to insert the start transaction marker before the first step. There may be one or more steps within our transaction. So what we need to do is, first of all, go to the steps toolbox. So click on view menu and click on steps toolbox. Now here in steps toolbox, let us find LR underscore start underscore transaction. So this is the step. This we place before the first step of our transaction. Now it asks for the transaction name, so we can give the transaction name. So let us call it login underscore transaction and click on the OK button. So VUgen automatically inserts the LR underscore start underscore transaction marker before the first step. Next, we need to put the end transaction marker. So let us find that in the steps toolbox. LR underscore end underscore transaction. And what we have to do is place this marker after the last step. So let us drag it and drop it after the last step. And it asks for the name of the transaction, which is login underscore transaction. Click on the OK button. So here we can see that the end transaction marker is placed. Now let us save our VUser script and we can replay it. When we replay it, Load Runner is going to measure the time it takes to complete all the steps within the start transaction and the end transaction markers. So let us replay the script. When the script replay is complete, we can go to the output pane and there we can see the details of our transaction that we have just implemented. So the replay is about to complete. And if we go to the HP WebTours web application in the itinerary, we can see that the flight reservation has been made. Let us clear this reservation because we are interested in finding out the details of our transaction. So let us scroll down. And here we can see that it says transaction login underscore transaction has started. And after the transaction is complete, it tells us what is the status of the transaction. It says login underscore transaction ended with a pass status, and it gives us the duration also. The duration here is 0.2986 seconds. So we can compare this duration with our performance requirements. So here the maximum acceptable response time for logging into the web application was 1 second, and it actually took 0.2986 seconds. So it was an acceptable response time. There is also wasted time given here. The wasted time is the time spent on tasks to support test analysis, so we can ignore it. Now let us copy this duration and store it here. Now one other thing we need to keep in mind is that the transaction time is going to be different when we replay our script in VueGen or run it in controller for a number of iterations. So let us change the number of iterations now. Click on replay, then click on runtime settings. In runtime settings, instead of giving as one iteration, we can give more iterations. Let us say 3 iterations here. Save it and replay our script one more time. Now as our VUser script is replaying in VueGen, we should note that in VueGen we can mark any number of transactions in the VUser script. However, the name of each transaction has to be different. And the controller measures the time it takes to perform each transaction. At present, the replay is going on. Once the replay is complete, we can go to the output pane and we can look for the transaction details that VueGen has captured during the replay, and we can notice whether our maximum acceptable response time is, whether the transactions that have occurred are within the maximum acceptable response time or not. Now the replay is complete. We can go to the HP WebTours web application and see that as per 3 iterations, it has made 3 flight reservations. And let us go back to the output pane. And here we can search for transactions. So here we can see that the first iteration transaction started. And here the first iteration transaction finished. And here the duration was 0.26 something seconds. Let us note this down here. Again, keep scrolling and search for the next transaction details. Here, the transaction in the second iteration has started and it is shown in the output pane in blue color. And here the duration was 0.3362 seconds. Let us paste it in Excel. And let us look at the transaction details of the third transaction also. So here we can see that this is the output for the third iteration. And here also the transaction passed and here we got a duration. Let us copy it and paste it in Excel. So here we can see that when we ran it for one iteration, we got a particular transaction time, but we ran it for multiple iterations, we got different transaction times. In performance testing, we are never going to get exactly the same transaction time. As long as our transaction times are within the maximum acceptable response time, we'll consider it to be a pass. So that is about transactions, and thank you for watching this video.